very much for those kind words. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a great pleasure for me as well to be here today to mark the 25th anniversary of the cooperation between the Heidelberg Center at Norwegian University and the Baltic State Technical University. And I think I can really echo all that has been said so far. Many wise and good and nice things about this unique cooperation. Let me also start by congratulating all of you who have made this partnership possible. And first of all, of course, the pioneers. Frode Melnik, Georgina Nevzorova, and many others. And also, I have to congratulate all those who have supported this initiative during the process in the beginning, throughout these decades, 25 years, quite some time. And it has also been very important to support that the program and the initiatives have got from Norwegian authorities, Russian authorities at the regional level and at the national level. And of course all the staff at the two universities, the students as well. Today, 20 years later, this is a vibrant and living partnership with lots of interaction, with joint programs, with student exchange, with joint events. I think 3,000 students have already taken part in this joint project and program. And many of you here today have graduated from these programs and others have been involved in one way or another. So why has this cooperation been so important? Why does it mean so much to us? How has it managed to be so vibrant, so dynamic over so long time? In short, what is the key to this cooperation success and what does it mean to future cooperation? Let me try to give some answers. Firstly, cooperation with Russia, our neighbor, has always been and will always be very important to Norway. For the last 25 years or so, we have been working with Russia to turn the border into a bridge. We have done so by intensifying our cross-border cooperation in a number of sectors, and research and higher education being one such sector. Today, relations on the political level, as we know, between Russia and the West are difficult. This comes as a result of Russia's violation of international law in Ukraine. And this has also affected our bilateral relations. Still, we do continue our cooperation in many areas, in areas of mutual interest, and I would say particularly in the north. Examples are sustainable fisheries management, nuclear safety, environmental cooperation, and search and rescue. And earlier this week, in fact, we had a meeting in the bilateral nuclear safety commission between Norway and Russia here in the Leningrad region at the nuclear power plant, and it was a very good and constructive meeting between State Secretary of the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Ukhta, and his Russian counterpart. We support also people-to-people contacts and cross-border cooperation today. And in addition to offering a high-quality education program, or many programs, within relevant topics, you have throughout these years contributed to people-to-people contact and cross-border cooperation. And I think this is this element, it has already been mentioned, I think it's really important and cannot be underestimated. On this point, I would also give credit to the partnership between Nordland County and Leningrad County, which will next year celebrate 30 years. I think that was really instrumental, that cooperation started, and we have actually also heard about that this morning, how that the start of that cooperation led into this cooperation. And I think my impression sitting here in St. Petersburg and close and to Leningrad region is that this is a partnership that is highly appreciated by the Leningrad authorities. Norway and Russia also cooperate constructively on Arctic affairs, on within the Barents Cooperation. And yesterday, in fact, our deputy minister also opened a Norwegian-Russian polar exhibition here in St. Petersburg, together with the vice president of the Russian Geographical Society. And that exhibition on Norwegian-Russian polar history is a testimony to the close cooperation that has existed between Northern Russia in the polar regions. And that history and common history dates back really a long time. Centuries of peaceful cooperation and relations between Norway and Russia along our common border in the north have laid a solid foundation for our cooperation in the Arctic. And at the seminar that followed the opening of the exhibition yesterday, we looked back on those historical ties, but we also looked at the successful cooperation that we are enjoying within the Arctic Council, which celebrates 20 years this year. And we also looked at some great examples of cooperation in the north between our two countries. And one of the two areas that were highlighted was the field of research and higher education. And within the field of research and higher education, this cooperation that we're celebrating today was put forward as one great example to be followed. Secondly, as the previous speaker mentioned, Russia is defined as a strategic partner to Norway in the field of education. That means that research and higher education is an important pillar in the Russian-Norwegian bilateral relationship. And the reasons have already been mentioned, but just briefly, Russia is our neighboring country. It is a fellow Arctic nation. It's one of the BRICS countries. It is a country with proud traditions, especially in mathematics and natural sciences. And cooperation, research cooperation between Norway and Russia goes back a long time. And the joint fisheries research is a great example. That started for more than 50 years ago. And that cooperation has enabled us to successfully regulate the stocks in the Barents Sea for the benefit of our own and future generations. Today, we cooperate in many fields. Medicine, as we mentioned, business and management, that's you, and others, resource management, natural sciences, and others. And this research cooperation, together with the education, you know, programs in Russia also support several Norwegian policy objectives. The Arctic, climate, energy, the environment, to mention some. And we're really glad to have a very active Norwegian University Center here in St. Petersburg. So within this research and education cooperation, we find you and your 25-year-long partnership. You were the very first one to start, and I think we can all agree that you are the most active one. It was a partnership that started thanks to a few pioneers, but it wouldn't have lasted for so long and it wouldn't go on today if it was not a genuine interest among students, among authorities, among the business, industry, this society at large for this cooperation. You have managed to develop a program which is relevant and which can contribute to many areas. Business, research, industry, to important challenges of the North in particular. And I think you in a very good way also managed to link different areas, link the research education to the business sector through your projects. In many ways you could say that the cooperation between the High North Center and the North University and Baltic State Technical University brings together the very best of two worlds. Business and management expertise from Buda, whereas PSTU is a leading engineering university. And students acquire competence that is attractive in the job market. I have myself really enjoyed talking to and listening to students who have graduated from these programs, and on Monday next week I'll take part in another graduation ceremony, and I'm very much looking forward. Thirdly, and finally, such a long and standing, strong and vibrant partnership would not have been possible without lots of enthusiasm, dedication and commitment. And I feel this commitment and enthusiasm through this cooperation both when I visit the Baltic State Technical University and when I visit Norwegian University. And I think we feel it here also today. And I think it comes from the fact that both sides see that, you know, there is a great relevance of this partnership. You know, normally you say 1 + 1 = 2, but here I think we see that 1 + 1 is at least 3 or probably more. So it's a partnership that has proved to be a great value to students, to the institutions, and also to our two countries. In a changing world, in changing circumstances, it is important to adapt, to develop, and to adjust to new realities, to new needs and interests. We all have to do that in order to be relevant. And I think the High North Center has been really good at doing this, and I think in fact it was your ability to do this and to be very innovative was the whole kind of start of this success story, that you at such an early point saw that here are some opportunities and you seized them. You were the first, and as we have said several of you, you are the most active cooperation. So I am also, like many others, looking forward to the next 25 years and our partnership that has to be continued to develop, to be based on good programs, on mutual interests, and a long-term perspective, and of course, a lot of enthusiasm. Thank you.